Ben Shapiro is currently having his moment in the sun. He's the new favorite commentator among young conservatives. Here's what he said on Christmas. I wanted to share this with everybody. Merry Christmas, and thank God America is a nation founded on Judea-Christian ideals. May that truth never change. So, you know, this is one of those things that people on the right have been saying forever, and at no point did it make any sense. It's just a feeling they have. It's just a feeling. I don't know. Bill O'Reilly used to say this, Sean Hannity. These are the kinds of people who say this. Probably Rush Limbaugh. We're a nation founded on Judeo-Christian values. But if you ask them to get specific, they can't give you any specifics. Why? Because they're making it up. They're utterly making it up. Now, look, half the things America was founded on were terrible. The other half were great. Were Enlightenment ideals. And what happens is, I notice a trend. What happens is, anytime you have, effectively, secular liberalism fight back against the forces of theocracy and evil and create a more just society, so whenever you have Enlightenment ideals winning the day, it's a case of, if you can't beat them, join them. That's what happens with the people on the right and with people who are more theocracy-minded. They go, no, everything good, we're going to take credit for. Wait, what? No, you can't just do that. You have to, you know, be objective about what actually unfolded and what actually happened. But no, they want to say, let's give credit. It's obviously Christianity, right? It's obviously, you know, religious values that led to America being great in every way. I mean, that's what I want to give credit for. Well, no, when you had societies that were, you know, bubbling over with Christian sentiment and were trying to base the government on such, what happened? You had the Inquisition, you had the Crusades, you had the fucking Dark Ages. I mean, this is what happens when you try to base, you know, a government on a religion, when you try to have theocracy. By the same token, look at, you know, Saudi Arabia today. They're Wahhabi. So they are fundamentalist Muslims, and in their society they say all atheists are terrorists. They behead people for sorcery and witchcraft. They cover women up from head to toe. So, listen, even if you're a religious person, you can understand that secularism makes sense. You want to give people the freedom to choose whatever they want to be, if they want to be religious or if they don't want to be religious. You don't want, you know, the government intertwined with religion, because that has nothing but downsides. So, I don't know, when they say America's a Judeo-Christian nation, that doesn't mean anything. You're just saying something, you're just saying words, but there's nothing attached to that. You're just fucking making noises. Hey, we're a Judeo-Christian nation, what does that mean? So I responded, Ben, how many times does the Constitution use the words God, Bible, Christianity, Judeo-Christian values again? I'll help you since you're a hack. Zero. The only time religion is mentioned at all is to guarantee free exercise of it and to have no establishment of it. So in other words, the only time religion is mentioned is to say, hey, you can exercise whatever religion you want to exercise, and we are going to be a secular nation. There is a separation of church and state. That's what they mean when they say you can have no establishment of a religion. So in other words, government's going to stay out of religious affairs. So this is... this is their old trick. Can't beat them, join them. Oh, we are not founded on Judeo-Christian values? Well, I'm just going to say we are, because that makes me feel better, because I'm triggered if you say we're not. I need my safe space, so I'm going to act like, you know, hey, this is how the country is founded. They do the same thing with Martin Luther King. Now you have so many people, they try to claim him. I'm sure you've seen it. The right tries to claim Martin Luther King. Like, oh, Martin Luther King, he was all about, you know, self- responsibility is what he was about. He's actually right-leaning. He's a conservative. You know, he would disagree with the liberals of today. Really, he would. Is that why he said the United States government is the greatest purveyor of evil on earth today? That's what Martin Luther King said. Is this the same guy who said inequality in healthcare is the worst form of inequality? A guy who railed against militarism, railed in favor of a single-payer system, who died while protesting for workers. It was for unions he was protesting when he got killed. So this is a man who was deeply committed to economic justice. He was deeply committed to these ideas that in no way you would associate with the right. But again, can't beat him, join him. Yeah, he was a Republican, and that's, you know, so he's like right-wing. It's the same shit that Ben Shapiro's doing here. Ah, America's founded on Judeo-Christian values. That's what we... No. We were half-founded on Enlightenment ideals, half were fucking monstrous barbarians, colonialists. So, that, you know, you got slavery, you know, you have the Native American genocide, which, by the way, these guys pretend like it doesn't exist. Hilarious. Dinesh D'Souza literally argued on Fox News that didn't happen. There was no Native American genocide. I don't know what you mean. So we're half-founded on disgusting, backwards colonialist ideals. Settler colonial society. And then we're half-founded on Enlightenment ideals. You know? Individual rights, free expression, free protest, secularism. So, but again, this is the trick. They'll pretend like the barbaric part of us doesn't exist, and then they'll say, oh, the good parts, because those are the only ones that exist, because obviously we're good by definition. The good parts, that's because of Judeo-Christian values. And then go ahead, point out that, that actually, wait a second, this is the first secular nation ever. The only time religion is mentioned is to guarantee free exercise of it and say no establishment of it. The Constitution, which is the ultimate law of the land, doesn't mention God, Bible, Christianity, or Judeo-Christian values. Those words don't show up at all. Point that out to them, and what? Fucking crickets. No response from Ben Shapiro. Perhaps because he knows I'm right.